Hey, Grace City Church, this is Pastor Kerry with Daily Lamplight, reading from 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 8. It starts off a little discouraging, but it gets really good. It says, "We do not want you to be uninformed about the troubles that we experienced. We were under great pressure, far beyond our ability to endure, so that we despaired of even life itself. Indeed, we felt we received the sentence of death, but this happened so that we would not rely on ourselves, but on God who raises the dead. He has delivered us from such a deadly peril, and he will continue to deliver us again. On him we have set our hope that he will continue to deliver us as you help us by your prayers." I think there's four things we can learn from the Apostle Paul this morning that God would want us to remember. Number one, understand that the pressure is real. The Apostle Paul was under such great pressure that he was almost crushed, and he was discouraged of even life itself. So just acknowledge that the pressure is real, and I can imagine that you're under great pressure today. But understand that God knows that, and he is with you. Number two, change your perspective about what you're going through. I believe more and more that faith or fear is a direct product of what we choose to focus on. And Paul said, in this passage, he says that this happened so that we would not rely on ourselves, but on God. Maybe, just maybe, what you're going through, what our country's going through, maybe this is happening so that we would stop relying on ourselves, which always ends in disaster, and that we would start relying on God. So change your perspective today about what you're going through. Third, remember that God has delivered you. He's delivered you from things like this before. You've been through things like this. You've been under great pressure and great stress, and yet God has been faithful to deliver you. So don't forget his goodness to you, and remember that he will continue to deliver you even through this, and that he will not stop being faithful to you. And lastly, pray for others. 2 Corinthians is all about comfort. Comforting others with the comfort that we've received from God our Father. So don't forget to text someone today, to reach out, to encourage someone. Don't hug them, but give them some love in through another way. Can't wait to see you again. We miss you. We pray for you. Don't forget to join us online tomorrow, Sunday, 10 a.m. And we cannot wait to when we can get together again. This too shall pass. We love you, Grace City. We are praying for you. Have a great day.